صلی علی رسوله الکریم اما بعد فاعوذ باللہ من الشیطان الرجیم بسم اللہ الرحمن الرحیم رب اشرح لی صدری ویسر لی امری واحلل عقدۃ من لسانی یفقہوا قولی جز 12 صوت القرآن we are doing a summary of جز 12 in English. Today we're gonna see سورۃ الحود complete سورہ and we're gonna start سورۃ الیوسف up to ayah number 52. Let's start, inshallah. So here, in the starting, we see Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Alif Lam Ra. Kitabul Uhkimat Ayatuhu Summa Fussilat Min Ladunna Hakimun Khabir. Alif Lam Ra. These are the hurufe muqattat, disjoint letters. This book whose verses are perfected and presented in detail from the one who's wise and acquainted. So here, Suratul Hud, and in this regard, Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, surah like Suratul Hud and other make me old. So we see like, you know, there are certain rules in this which make you remind of the Akhirah. And here further we see, and saying, seek forgiveness of your Lord and repent to Him. He will let you enjoy a good provision. So here in ayah number 3, وَإِنَ اسْتَغْفِرُوا رَبَّكُمْ. Ask استغفر, forgiveness from your Rabb, and repent to Him, and He will let you enjoy a good provision for a specified time, and give every doer of favor His favor. So whatever you are doing good, Allah will give you. But if you turn away, then indeed I fear for you the punishment of great day. So one is taghfiru rabbakum, seek forgiveness from your Lord. Hassan al-Basri, he once hired a porter and he heard from him saying that the entire length of journey, Alhamdulillah, astaghfirullah. So Hassan al-Basri, eventually he asked him, you know, that what is the matter with you? How come you keep saying either astaghfirullah or Alhamdulillah? Don't you say anything else? So he said that I have learned half of the Quran and I have come to learn that the servant is between two matters. Either he is enjoying a blessing and has come to him from Allah, or for the gratitude is due. And that is why I say I'm enjoying it. So I'm saying Alhamdulillah. Or the servant is in state of disobeyed. So he don't want to for which istighfar is due. So I say astaghfirullah. So Hassan al-Basri, he said to himself, this porter is more sensible than, he's telling to himself, this porter is more sensible than you. Because this is the reality that either we enjoy the gifts of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for which, all the time we need to be grateful to Him, saying Alhamdulillah. Or we have done something wrong, which we need to beg forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, asking astaghfirullah. When a person seeks astaghfirullah from Allah, what happens, then Allah will let you hear, yumitukum matauna hasana ila ajalim musamma. Allah will let you enjoy a good provision for a specified term, and give every doer of favor His favor. Mean astaghfirullah, a person receives benefit even in his life. So we have to do astaghfirullah. In ayah number 6, وَمِن دَابَّةٍ فِي الْأَرْضِ إِلَّا عَلَى اللَّهِ رِزْقُهَا. And there is no creature on earth but that upon His its provision. وَيَعْلَمُ مُسْتَقَرَّهَا وَمُسْتَعُودَهَا. And He knows its place of dwelling and its place of storage. كُلُّ فِي كِتَابٍ مُبِينٍ. And Allah is in clear register. So here, every creature, Allah is the one who provide for it. Just think about unaccountable makhluq, the unaccountable creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that just lives on this earth. And if we tried counting the bugs or which are in our house, even if we won't be able to do it, all the creatures I'm talking about, if you see outside, every bird flies and, some creatures, they crawl. But we are not able to count it. But here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, what is amazing is that each creature has own unique needs, has its unique food. If you give the food of a cat to a squirrel, Does it suit? No, it won't suit and they won't take it. So here he knows its place of dwelling and also place of storage, meaning Allah knows where each creature lives, where it's alive, where its unique address is, and where it moves from one location to other, when it migrates from one place to other, then Allah still knows where. Allah knows its abode. So here, home of one animal, home of birds, everything Allah knows. So here, kullu kitabin mubeen, and also when they die, where they will be deposited, that also Allah knows. And here, kullu fi kitabin mubeen, it is all recorded. Where? In clear register. What is the clear register? Luhi mahfuz. Imagine that Allah knows about it and He has all, every detail of the universe with Himself. In this we learn, like, you know, the knowledge, he has complete knowledge and comprehensive knowledge, that there is nothing except that Allah is aware of. He is the one who owns it, where each creature is going, where its food lies. He is the one who provides for its provision, and then He has also given the ability to go, find its provision and benefit from it. So there is a hadith regarding that. Prophet ﷺ said, if you relied upon Allah like the creation relies, then you would be like the birds who go out of their homes, empty stomach, every morning. Then what happens when they return? They are full-bellied in the evening. And there is one more hadith. Prophet ﷺ said, where the son of Adam run from his provision the way he runs from death, do people hide from death? Do people try to escape death, avoid death? Yes, they do. So if son of Adam were to run from his provision, from his money, from his food, the way he runs from the death, his provision would reach him, just as death would reach him. You know, whatever it may be, but Allah will give you whatever the provision, meaning there is no avoiding the provision that Allah has decreed for His servants. And here further we move to other ayahs, inshallah. Here we see in ayah number 16, أُولَٰئِكَ الَّذِينَ لَيْسَ لَهُمْ فِي الْآخِرَةِ إِلَّا النَّارِ. Those are the ones for whom there is not in hereafter but fire. Why? Because they never desired Jannah. When they never desired Jannah, then what will happen in the hereafter? They will not get Jannah. Then where is it? Like, what is the only other option left? Jahannam, hellfire. And lost is what they did therein, meaning whatever they did in this worldly life, it will be lost. Whatever they accumulated, whatever they collected in this dunya, it will be lost. Because when a person dies, what happens? No matter how much money he has collected, can he get it? No, in the grave, no way. And even if he dies, can it benefit him in the afterlife? No one. On the day of judgment, if a person were to offer an earth filled of gold to ransom himself from the hellfire, it won't be accepted, never. So only in the grave, what we are taking? Only our deeds. So here it says, وَحَبِتَ مَا سَنَوْ فِيهَا. Whatever they acquired, whatever they earned, whatever they produce in the worldly life, it will be worthless. وَبَاطِلٌ مَا كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ. And worthless what they used to do. Why? Because it died in the world. There's a hadith, Umm Salima, she asked Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, Ya Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, Hashim bin Mughira, he was a man from the time of Jahiliyyah, who died before Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam received the prophethood. But this man was known for his generosity, he was known for his kindness towards people. So she said that this man used to join ties of kingship. He used to host and honor the guest and so forth. He used to free the slaves and, you know, feed others and everything. But he would have accepted, but he didn't, if he were alive today, he would have accepted Islam. So the deeds that he performed, will it benefit or not? So Prophet ﷺ said no. For he gave it for dunya and its name and praise. Means whatever he did, he got it in this world only. On the day of judgment, nothing will be getting for him. So whatever the amal, whatever the deeds we are doing, we have to check ourselves. In ayah number 25, وَلَقَدْ أَرْسَلْنَا نُوحًا إِلَىٰ قَوْمِهِ إِنِّي لَكُمْ نَزِيرٌ مُبِينٌ. And we had certainly sent Nuh alayhi salam to his people saying, indeed, I am to you a clear warner. So here every prophet, whoever comes, the only message is, inni lakum nazirum mubin. I am here to warn you clearly. So the eminent among those who disbelieved from his people said, we do not see you but as a man like ourselves. They said like that. We do not see you followed except by those who are lowest of us. Like, you know, they are thinking because they are elite people and only what they see, because of the arrogance and pride, they are saying only lowest, means they are ridiculing the people who believe it. Because most of them, they don't have that much money. So it doesn't matter, you know, whether you have money or not. The only matter, you believe in Allah and you follow Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam sunnah. So here, rather we think you are liars. Every time, whenever the prophets come, they keep on rejecting. So here in Surah Hud, later we see here in ayah number 41, وَقَالَ إِرْكَبُوا. And now finally, you know, most of the people didn't believe. Only few of them, handful of people, you could say. So then to Nuh alayhi salam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did wahi and said, now you embark there in the name of Allah and its course and its anchoring. Like, you know, actually Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala explained to him how the ship should be and who will be embark in the ship. So indeed, my Lord is forgiving and merciful. وَقَالَ إِرْكَبُوا فِيهَا بِسْمِ اللَّهِ مَجْرِيهَا وَمُرْسَاهَا إِنَّ رَبِّي لَغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ. So now he started, like, you know, boating the ship. And it sailed with them through waves like mountains. Now they are going in the ship, and it was like, you know, the waves are such a huge waves. And Nuh al-Islam called to his son who was apart from them. Oh my son, come aboard with us and be not with the disbelievers. So he's asking, son, come on, come embark in the ship. But he said, I will take refuge on a mountain to protect me from the water. He's not mounting. He said, no, I'm going to go there and I'm going to be safe. Nuh alayhi salam said, there is no protector today from the decree of Allah except for whom he gave mercy. Only Allah gave mercy. And the waves came between them and he was among the drowned. And he was drowned in front of his father and he couldn't able to do anything. Because he is not doing the itaat of Allah. So he was drowned in front of him. And here later on we see, Qala ya nu. He said, oh no, indeed he is not of your family. Your son that was destroyed, no, he was not of your family, even though the blood bond exists. Now this blood bond has been terminated. Why? Because he's not believing, he's not a believer. So don't be grieved, you know, don't be sad. Innahu laysa min ahlika, indeed he is not of your family. Innahu amalun ghayra sali, indeed he's the one who work was the other than righteous. So ask me not for the about which you have no knowledge. Indeed, I advise you lest you among the ignorant. So man zallazi, here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, you know, whatever you know, like you don't have the knowledge what I know. You look for, like, you know, he's your son, but actually he is not a believer anymore. And here in ayah number 47, قَالَ رَبِّ إِنِّي أَعُوذُ بِكَ. Nuh alayhi salam, immediately he repent to his Lord. So Nuh alayhi salam, now he realized his mistake, you know, because his son is not, you know, from Saleh, he can't make dua. So now he's asking forgiveness. My Lord, I seek refuge in you from asking that of which I have no knowledge. And unless you forgive me and have mercy upon me, I will be among the losers. You know, wa illa taghfirli wa tarhamni akun min al khasirin. So what we learn from this, whether your aqrabain, your own parents, your children, if they are not Muslims, no one can help. So ask forgiveness. So why forgiveness? Because he asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what about my son? So he said, he is not from you, he is not among you. وَإِلَىٰ آدٍ أَقَاهُمْ هُودًا Ayah number 50. And to Ad we send their brother Hud. The Prophet is called the brother of their nation. He said, O my people, worship Allah. Every prophet, they believe in Islamic monotheism. They said, people, worship Allah. And you have no deity other than him. Means no shirk. You are not but inventors of falsehood. So now we see later on, like other prophets also, they brought that Islamic monotheism. We only say that some of our gods have possessed you with evil. He said, indeed, I call Allah to witness and witness yourself that I am free from whatever you associate with Allah. Now, in ayah number 54, I have told you clearly that you should not worship these idols. Whatever the idols are there, you shouldn't worship. But still, they were clinging on to it. You know, they were still believing it and they want to. And inni barau mimma tushrikun. He said, no, I'm not, you know, I dissociate myself. I'm not going to be associate with this. Only I associate with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Meaning, I do not agree with this at all. I do not accept it. Means whatever the shirk you are doing, it's on your own. I'm not involved in this. And in ayah number 61, وَإِلَىٰ سَمُودُ أَقَاهُمْ صَالِحًا And to Samud we send his brother Saleh. He said, O my people, worship Allah. And you have no deity other than him. He has produced you from the earth and settled you in it. So ask forgiveness of him and then repent to him. Indeed, my Lord is near responsive. قَرِيبٌ مُجِيبٌ So every prophet they are saying, believe in one Allah and do not do shirk. But still, even though the same message has been given, but those who have proud and arrogance, they were rejecting. And whenever messengers, the angels came to Lut, he was anguished for them and felt for them great discomfort. So here in ayah number 77, we see the people of Lut, they were involved in homosexual. And when the angels came, he was scared and anguished. Why? Because even with the angels, they want to do that bad thing. And now he's trying to explain to the people, please leave them, don't do that. And he also requested, like, you know, I have daughters, you can get married to them. You know, this is the fitrah. Men should get married to women. It's not like women and men. Islam completely prohibits that. And there is no such thing like homo or lesbians. But here, Lut al-Islam is requesting, you don't do this. And these people, they actually openly do that. You know, openly in front of publicly. One is like, you know, privately something is doing. But they used to do openly and they don't even hasten to do that. And now he's saying, do the halal thing and get married to the woman. Why you are doing this? But instead of listening, they were not. They were rejecting and they were so engrossed. Because if you are in haram, you get so much engrossed, you don't want to leave that. Here we see in ayah number 95, كَانَ لَمْ يَغْنُوا فِيهَا And they had never prospered therein then away with the Madian as Samud was taken away. Later on, many prophets were mentioned and how they were destroyed because first Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent the message, then later on this thing happened. And Suratul Yusuf, this is the one surah in which you learn the whole story about Yusuf al-Islam. And the same thing will go on in the complete surah. And we did certainly said Musa with our signs and a clear authority. And here, later on in that, you know, how Musa al-Islam came with the ayahs and so on. But let's start Suratul Yusuf because we already know every prophet brought the same message believing in one Allah. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, Alif Lam Ra. These are the verses of clear book. These are the huruf-e-muqattat and Allah knows the meaning of it. Indeed, we have sent it down an Arabic Quran that you might understand. This is the Quran which is in Arabic. We relate to you, O Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the best of the stories, qasasul, best of the stories that what we have revealed to you of this Quran, although you were before it among the unaware. So what does it mean? The story of Yusuf al-Islam was informed through Wahi. Because, you know, the here we learn that on suggestion of Jews and Mushrikeen of Makkah, they asked Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam about Yusuf Alaihi Wasallam. They went to Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam and they were asking, because the Arabs, they did not know about Yusuf Alaihi Wasallam at all. They did not know what happened and all those. So Jews, they said, oh, let's test him, you know. So what happened? They asked about Yusuf Alaihi Wasallam. Allah revealed entire story of Yusuf Alaihi Wasallam in great detail, and through the story he taught indirectly, directly all the things, how the things should be. And here also it was consoling the heart of Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. So here we see Yusuf Alaihi Wasallam, he saw the dream and he mentioned to his father, you know, I saw a dream. And father said, no, not to mention in front of your brothers. And later on, this dream will come true in the end. We will see in the next Juz, inshallah. Here, later on, what happens? He loves Yusuf Alaihi Wasallam so much, but always they were jealous with him. Their brothers always say, why you love him so much, and you know, you always talks about him. So in the jealousy, they thought, you know, they going to plan something so that they going to kill Yusuf. And according to the plan, they went and they make some excuse. We want to take him to outside and he can enjoy with us. And he said, no, perhaps, you know, you won't be able to take care. Who said? Yaqub al-Islam. They said, no, we are, you know, a group. They always used to, whenever they want, because they always say, oh, we are group. We are shatta, you know, we are a group and we can take care of them. And so what happened? They took him and, you know, and later on they were playing and so, and finally they put him in the well, because they don't want him to come with them, and that's how they want to get rid of Yusuf al-Islam. So they said, kill Yusuf or throw out to another land. The face of your father will then be only for you, and you will be after that a righteous people. Look at the ayah. They are saying, okay, we'll do like this and later on we'll be righteous. So what are they discussing over here? The brothers of Yusuf al-Islam, that they are going to kill them, throw them and get rid of Yusuf al-Islam. And after that, they will do good and they will be good. And they are thinking one more thing, that, you know, because he will be away and they can remove the love from, you know, Yaqub al-Islam. So, you know, when somebody loves, parents especially, if they love some child, it will be there in their heart, even though if the child is there or not, doesn't matter. The love is so much. But you know, the shaitan, it attacked them so much, and they crossed all the limits, and then they did this thing. And here, later on, we see the house story moves. قَالَ قَائِلٌ مِّنْهُمْ, said a speaker among them, like, who was that? The eldest of the brothers. He said, do not kill Yusuf. Now, he was very sensible. He said, but throw them into the bottom of the well. Some travelers will pick up, and if you would do something, they said, our father, why did you entrust us with the Yusuf, while indeed we are to him sincere counselors. You know, now after going, and you know, Yaqub al-Islam said, indeed it saddened me that you should take him, and I fear that wolf would eat, and while you are of him unaware. You know, he's a prophet too. So, but he's not directly saying, indirectly saying, so that they should understand and they shouldn't take. Even though he said so, they took it. They said, if a wolf should eat him while we are strong clan, indeed we would then the losers. They were trying to lie their father, and that's how they took it. So here there's a hadith. Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, whoever does not give up false statement and evil deeds and speaking bad words to other than Allah is not in need of his fasting, or not in need of worship, not in need of ibadah. So Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, lying and truthfulness cannot be together in one place. And especially he emphasized that, you know, a believer cannot lie. And finally they get rid of the Yusuf al-Islam and they throw in the well. And there came a company of travelers and they sent their water drawer. This is in ayah number 19. And he let down his bucket and he saw, hashalillah, there's good news. What happened? You know, like, you know, there is a ghulam, there is a boy, And they were so happy to found him because they can use him as a slave. And they sold him for a reduced price. Few dirhams they took him, they took out, and now they send it. And then they sold to some price. وَقَالَ الَّذِي اِشْتَرَاهُ. The one whom from Egypt who bought him said to his wife, now a person from Egypt, he bought it. Make his residence comfortable. Now he came with him and he is telling to the wife, make his residence comfortable. Perhaps he will benefit us. And now they don't have children. And what he's saying, oh, we will adopt him as a son. He's saying, okay, we don't have children. We will adopt him as a son. Thus, we establish Yusuf al-Islam in the land. We might teach the interpretation of the events. And later on, he grow young. And then that woman, she started, you know, enticing. And he was alone. And she tried to seduce. Like, you know, remember her husband said, we're going to adopt. But when he got matured, Ashuddha, and like he was a young boy, he was very handsome. And then she started, you know, enticing it. And here in ayah number 25, and they both raised on the door and she tore his shirt from the back. You know, he want to protect himself. He want to be chaste, Yusuf al-Islam. So they found her husband at the door. She said, what is the recompense of one who is indeed evil for your wife? You know, now she's lying. She's saying, oh, he is doing evil with me. I'm not doing. So he has to be imprisoned or has to be given painful punishment. So Yusuf al-Islam said, it was she who sought to seduce me. In ayah number 26, and a witness from her family testified, you know, its shirt is torn from the front, then she has told the truth. If she is a liar, it will be from the back. This is like, you know, circumstantial evidence. And now it was proved like it was from the back, and husband knows, like, you know, she is lying. Even though she was lying, Yusuf Arid and Hahaza. Yusuf al-Islam ignore this and seek forgiveness for the sin, and indeed you were the sinful. And woman in this, now he went to the prison, he is spending there. And because when she attacked that time, Yusuf al-Islam make dua, he want to be chaste. He said, I want to be chaste, and he asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah saved him, protect his chastity. And then later on, that woman was not shy to tell to other people, you know, he's so handsome, if you look at him, you know, you can't able to protect yourself, you can't stop watching him, you know. And after that, she asked some woman, okay, you can cut the fruits when he is passing by. And what happened, you know, when he was passing by, they actually cut their fingers. So that's how it happened. And look at, like, when he is in prison, there two young men came. And there entered the prison with him two young men. One of them said, indeed, I have seen myself in a dream pressing wine. The other said, indeed, I have seen myself carrying upon my head some bread from which the birds were eating, in form of its interpretation. And they say, you know, we see you inna naraka minal muhsinin. They said, indeed, we see you as a muhsin, you know, one who do at most good. And then later on, he said the interpretation of the dream. He said, you will not receive food that is provided to you, except that I will inform you of its interpretation before it comes. So he was doing, you know, here we learn the, you know, how you should do tabligh. So before the food comes, I'm going to tell you. And he said, you know, this is from my Lord has taught me. Indeed, I have left the religion of a people who do not believe in Allah. He said, I don't do shirk. I believe in one Allah. And in the hereafter, other disbelievers. And I have followed the religion of my father, Ibrahim al-Islam, Isaac and Yaqub. So he availed that time and he conveyed the message. And meanwhile, he said the interpretation of that. And later on, these two prisoners, they were released. And then he said, before they were going, he said, okay, you should tell to your king that, you know, I am in the prison. But they forgot. And it says, the scholar says, the interpretation of that, Allah, like it was the hikmah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And later on, the king, he had some dream and he want to know the interpretation of that. That time they remind, oh, that was the thing, you know, we met to Yusuf al-Islam. And that dream was, and king said, indeed, I have seen in a dream seven fat cows being eaten by seven that were lean, and seven green spikes of green, and other they were dry. The eminent ones explained to me my dream. If you should interpret the dreams, you know, then they ask. So they remember, oh, that like, you know, we met Yusuf al-Islam. Perhaps, you know, we can ask him. And then they ask, okay, we can go and ask him. So he interpreted the dream. Like, you know, he said, 7 years you will have more, you know, fertile food and everything, but 7 years you will have famine, and you have to you know, protect your whatever the food you have to protect it and keep it in the such a way that you can protect it for 7 more years. That's how it's gonna be. And he spoke to him, and then when he was talking to Yusuf al-Islam, and he said, you know, I can be a treasurer. He tell himself, you know, I can take care of the treasure and I can do this work. So he himself is telling who Yusuf al-Islam is saying. And then he was hired. And here later on, when he came out, he want to clear the matter. Here what happened, said king to the woman, now the king takes the matter in his own hand. Just imagine they threw him in the prison without even proving he was not guilty. And now finally the king said, what happened, what was the matter with you? And he was saying, you know, that wife of Aziz, she tried to seduce me and she is lying, and that was proved. So we learn from this, even though he was not guilty, he went to prison, he spent the years, he asked Allah subhanahu ta'ala, sometimes, you know, your matter delays. You have to ask Allah subhanahu ta'ala again and again, even though you are right, but Allah delayed the matter, and then clearly, you know, haq and batil was clear, like it was proved, the woman was guilty, and Yusuf al-Islam was, you know, he was chaste. So we learn from this so many lessons in Surah Yusuf. We learn so much, subhanallah. So this, here we end this juz. Subhanakallahumma bihamdika, nashhadu an la ilaha illa anta, nastaghfiruka, natubu.